All right, I've got an Xbox 360. Had a 3-ring of death on it. I've already repaired it once by doing the overheating inside the board by putting some nuts and bolts on it, pulling down the processor to the board. I've since bought myself a nice solder station here, and now I'm going to use the solder station for about 45 seconds to heat the board and put the chip back together. Over here, I've got some liquid flux that I'm gonna put on here in just a moment. I've already had it heating up here. I've got my preheat element set to about 150. We're gonna, that's Celsius, and we're gonna fry it at about 240 degrees Celsius. So we hope we're gonna get a good connection on this once we get it soldered back together. I'm gonna do the GPU and I'm gonna do the CPU, both with the some liquid flux on. So we'll go ahead and add some liquid flux to it, and we'll get ready to fry it here for about, I said about 45 seconds roughly. So I'm just going to take this, pick the board up, just going to put some down inside the board here, kind of working on in there a little bit. Should be a plenty. Looking right in there real good. Set it back in here. So we're going to lock her down. Looks pretty good there. Drop this down, and go ahead and fry. 45 seconds is all I'm looking for here. See the flux already bubbling. I'll watch, keep my eyes on it real good. About 30 seconds left. See, everything's heating up, drying off. Be very careful, we don't want to fry the chip. About 15 seconds. Smoke coming off. And we'll let this one go through. That's going to be it for that side. So we'll go ahead and loosen this up. And we'll move this one out of the way. Now we're going to go ahead and get ready to do the processor itself. It's going to add a little bit of flux to it as well. Be careful, the board's probably going to be hot here. It is no clean flux, so all you have to do is just get ready to go ahead and put it back together once we get done here. I am about 30 millimeters off the board, roughly. This should get us going pretty good. Get my timer set here. Just counting. Looks pretty good there. All 15 seconds left, roughly. And we'll let this one out here finish. And we'll call this done. And that's it. Okay, we're back. Got everything assembled, stuck in here. Still got to put a few other things together. All my screws to hold on the motherboard from underneath and all, but we're just going to throw it back together and test it real quick. So let's go ahead and grab a, let's see, the power cable, HDMI cable, and we'll plug these in real quick. And power cable's not long enough. All right, pull that over here. You see it here. Let's see if we can raise this up. You can kind of see the TV a little bit, which is right over here. And we'll turn the lights on. I think you can see everything. Yeah, your light's here. TV there. Power. Yeah, I got all my lights. So I'm going to do this from here. Xbox is running. Game. We got in here and we are good. All right, and it's reading a disc, whatever was in there. All right, so that's it. I'm gonna put it back together and we'll be playing here in a little bit. Okay, Xbox is loaded back up right over here, and we're gonna turn it on with the remote. See the Xbox remote comes on. There it is right there coming on. No red light anymore. And there she is. Running like a champ. And there we are. Beautiful Xbox working just fine. With the Kinect.